Okay, thank you. Are you bored with Nemo? No? Okay. So I promise this is the last talk for the weekend about this topic. You can stay one more week. So you got the presentation yesterday about how similar the situation is when you are a crew member in Nemo and a crew member in the space station. And if you can send the pictures in parallel, yeah. And this morning you got a more intimate presentation about what it is when you live underwater and what are your feelings and your thoughts. Now I will talk about the EVA program and what we did in Nemo, why we did EVAs, what it is about. So there should be some picture that we will run around here, so as soon as possible. So what we did in Nemo, you know that this mission, Nemo 19, was simulating a mission with a permanent time delay of 5 minutes between the Aquarius module, where the crew was, and between the control center. And in this 5 minutes delay are typically the type of delay that you can have between the Earth and Mars. When the Earth and Mars are in opposition, they are close together, you have the Sun, the Earth and Mars, and this is typically what could be. So we are simulating a mission where basically we were doing exploration first around asteroids or moon of Mars in microgravity, and then we were supposed to be landed on the Mars planet and to do exploration. So the objective were for NASA to define how a crew can be autonomous in the scheduling and the implementation of an EVA, because you can imagine that if you have a question, you cannot ask the question and wait for 10 minutes to get the feedback. And or we can anyway find a solution to have the ground control giving enough support to the crew. So we did different type of EVAs. The first one was about around a structure which was a boom that we could deploy. And we have like this one, you see. And at the extremity of this boom, we put a drill machine. And the objective was to drill, to do core drilling in the surface to get some sample from deep from below the surface. So we did this in microgravity, in neutral buoyancy, and then we did exactly the same EVA later on, but in partial gravity with additional weight to simulate the Mars gravity. So we are going outside each time for 4 hours. We did another similar EVA with instead of replaced the drilling machine by a foot restraint platform, and we are also assisted by a robot, kind of rover that was floating around and piloted by one of the other crew members inside Aquarius. So in these simulations, we were attached by the feet with a foot restraint platform, and we were doing some sampling of the soil, sampling of rocks, or ship sampling on big rocks. And you can see here the platform that we are deploying. And basically, one astronaut was attached at the extremity and could rotate, could do the work, while the other one was rotating the boom. And we had a position where we were 45 degrees on the left. Then we extended the boom, then 90 degrees on the right, and then we retracted the boom. So there were four locations to perform the activity. And we did it in microgravity and in 1G. We had also this also fancy vehicle, to kind of diver delivery system that was we could use a kind of underwater GPS to pilot it. And this was for the last EVA, type of EVAs where we did exploration, like you can see here, on the surface of Mars. And these explorations, basically, we are using a map like this one, and we had four big sites to explore. And from each site, we had to radiate in different directions to find six different geological features or elements that were supposed to be mapped already by rovers, and that we had to go for exploration. And when we found the object, we had to do some measurement, the orientation compared to the waypoint, and the different size. And we took pictures. And when we did the pictures of these elements, we continued to do the exploration. The pictures were sent to the ground. The ground received them 5 minutes later. They did the analysis, and then the specialists in the back room said, oh, here we have a specific feature that we see on your photo, and this is much more interesting than what you have seen. So we want you to go back there and to do the analysis of this, and then to find another feature like that on your own. So what we did, the strategy was to come back after 20 minutes, 30 minutes to the same exploration point, and then we got the information from the IV astronaut inside the Aquarius, who received the picture and the recommendations from the ground control, and he told us, okay, now if you recall the one that you have seen, if you go more on the left side in this direction, such a distance, you should find something which looks like that, and this is where you have the new feature that the scientists are looking for. And then we identified, we could show that on the camera, and said, oh, that's the right one, and then we have to find another one by yourself. So this strategy works very well, we don't lose time. What I also wanted to mention is that this is not only exploration simulation, we are talking about real explorations. Many times during the EVA, and there were some EVAs that we developed on our own, we decided to go on different sites on our own, on each site. And I recall one EVA, for example, when I was about 75 meters away from Aquarius, I was 50 meters away from Andreas Mogensen. The visibility was 10 meters, so which means that the only thing that you see is that your umbilical is vanishing in the blue after 10 meters. You feel, and the divers that are supporting us, after a while, they have to come back to the boat to refill their tank. And so you could find yourself in such a situation that for 30 minutes or more, you are alone. Alone, you don't see anything around, you hear your partner, and you have to find something that on a location that you don't know where it is, and you don't know the environment, and you have some maps, and you have to find out. And we were really thinking at that time, wow, this is no more a simulation. We are really doing exploration. And the fact that by these missions, NEMO missions, they can put the crew members doing an EVA in a state of mind where they feel that it is real, that they really do an exploration. This is very important for the feedback and for what we can get out of these missions. So here you see some of the core, some of the chip sampling that we did with when we attached by the feet, and you have seen also in these pictures when we did the exploration. So we used a kind of wheel to measure the distance, and we had also a kind of compass to check the orientation. Do you have questions?
Thanks for your talks about NEMO.
You want one more? No, just kidding.
What do you miss the most about being there?
This is what I told this morning, the module, the experience. The EV experience was amazing, for sure. The space station-like crew experience was also great. What I miss more is the underwater experience and the feeling of being part of this module and what I told this morning. Because we know that we will never go back. I mean, I will keep on supporting the missions, but I cannot go back again in the module. There will be other astronauts that will rotate there. I will support them the best I can, but this is an experience of one experience in your life.
Is it on?
Yeah.
From a planning perspective, did your ground team know that you were doing 20-minute rotations? For instance, would they give you your instructions 5 minutes?
Yes, this was already pre-agreed. So this was a strategy that we developed with the ground so that we could have enough time for them to analyze the images and the data that we were sending, that they can send the information back with a time delay, and then we came back at the same location. So we were not waiting, they were not waiting. It's just that you do the exploration, you repeat your cycle.
So did you, for instance, did you hear, was it like you were talking with no delay? Did you get the instructions as you came to the site?
We got real-time instruction from the EVA, the IV astronaut inside Aquarius. So with our partner inside Aquarius, which is like the one inside the space station when you are outside for an EVA, with this guy we're in real-time talking. And the ground control could listen to this talking, but only with 5 minutes delay. And what was great also is that they let us, for the last EVAs, to develop ourselves our strategy and say, okay, now you guys, you are fully autonomous in the decision because you know better the setup and the environment than we. But of course, the day before we had a briefing and we had to explain what was our plan and to have this agreed by the ground control. There is never the situation where you say, oh, I want to go outside and let's see what I can look for.
All right, thank you very much. Thank you for the talk.
You're welcome.